So now let's put them all together into a single piece of software. Now up front, it took me about a whole day to do this. So I'm not going to ask you to do it all yourself because it's going to cost you probably at least an hour if it takes me a day. But I still want to be able to take all the lessons that we did together into a single system. So I'm going to help you a little bit, bits and pieces. But up front, here is the environment that I wrote for you, which is very much derived from the environment we studied in the past. We have a class robot that has certain kind of noise characteristics you can find over here. And as I scroll down, you can see the familiar init function, the position setting function, the set noise function. And then we have two checking functions, whether we have a collision with a world called grid, which I'll show you in a minute. And we have a check goal function to see if we reached a goal according to a certain distance threshold. The move function should be very familiar at this point. It applies noise to the motion command. It's the same code that you originally wrote. And then we have a very simple sense function, which measures the robot's XY location similar to a GPS on a car, but with substantial measurement noise. Corresponding to this sense function, we have a measurement probability function that you might want to use in your filter, and it evaluates the probability of a measurement relative to the ground truth coordinates of the robot using Gaussians. Armed with all this, here is the problem. I'm going to give you a grid. Here's an example grid. Let me draw this for you. This specific one happens to be of dimension 6 and 5, and there are a number of blocked-off cells like this. And if you look carefully into the code, you'll find information about the initial starting location on the left upper corner and the goal location, which is the bottom right corner. So in putting everything together, we're going to build a robotic car using our bicycle model. They'll drive through the free space, through the continuous free space, on something close to the shortest path, all the way into the goal. So here is my solution that I implemented, and that you will get to see for most parts towards the end of this class. I'm starting up over here. These are my obstacles. They're implemented as circles to the center of these grid cells. Not exactly correct, but good enough for my implementation. And here are multiple runs using the same code. And you can see they're far from optimal. They are non-optimal because there's control noise and there's also measurement noise. But they all make it safely through free space into the corner where the goal objective is. If you look at them in detail, like this solution over here, you'll find that the spacing of the circles is somewhat variable. You'll find that there's little corners over here that are either the result of control noise, or of measurement noise, or of my somewhat deficient implementation. And you also find the control set points that are the smooth points of my A star planner, as shown here in green. In the version that I implemented for you, the controller does something very, very different. It actually chooses as the control objective to head straight to the goal using the A102 function, executes the action at a speed of 0.1, and then reports a collision whenever the robot is moving. And just looking down to the output, where we see the robot's coordinates along with the orientation, there's very frequent collisions that the robot undergoes in its attempt to reach the goal, which it eventually does, but you can see two big regions of collisions until the goal is finally reached.